This time I'd like to introduce and add some very instrumental in my search for renewal as of 2000 and a great pastor, Terry Goode.
Thank you, Steve. Lord bless every one of you. Thanks for coming. I pray that every one of you will feel the presence of the Lord here today, because as we honor Dorla, we do so knowing that she's in the presence of the Lord. We do so knowing that we ourselves, that are alive and remain, can look forward to being with her someday as the Lord gives us that privilege and as we come into His presence. He tells us in His Word, if two or three are gathered in His name, He'd be in the midst of us. And so we're going to open with prayer here before we get into the Word here, and pray that God will just touch your hearts and direct us as we continue this service. Lord, we thank you this day for people. We thank you, Lord, that you died for us, Lord, that you love us so much. And we thank you, Lord, as we celebrate life, as we celebrate Dorla Streight this day, Lord. We celebrate her life, and we celebrate it because of you, Lord. You come to bring life, and that more abundantly. We thank you, Lord, as you give us assurance in your word, Lord, that we too can have eternal life through you, Lord Jesus. We ask you now that you'll come by the comfort of your Holy Spirit and move upon every one of our lives, cause us to reflect on our own lives, even as we've heard the great things about Dorla this day, cause us to be conscious of our own lives and how we all affect one another. We give you praise and glory for all these things, Lord. We thank you for moving and working in our midst this day. We give you praise for it in Jesus' name. Amen. Dorla M. Streight, 82 when she passed away, lived at 100 Glen Ridge Drive in East Peoria. She died at 1:15 a.m. Thursday, March the 8th, 2012, at Morton Villa Care Center. She was born February the 14th, 1930, in Pekin, to Dewey and Velma Guile. She married William E. Streight on July the 22nd, 1950. He preceded her in death in 1989. Surviving her three sons, Steve, Jim, and Don, my grandson, Leland Streight, two sisters, Jeannie Rogers and Teresa Blanchett, one brother, Alan Guy, and three granddaughters. It's great to have family and friends. Sometimes these are the only occasions when families get together. Sometimes, you know, it's weddings or funerals that we only see each other. But whatever the occasion, it's good to have family and friends meet together. And particularly in a case like that, when we come to honor a loved one, one that's gone on before us. Psalms 116:15 tells us, precious in the sight of the Lord is the death of the saints. You see, God considers it an important thing when we live, but He also thinks it's great when we die because we can meet with Him. Promises eternal life. And I've always found my words are very little, they have very little effect and may bring little comfort. However, I know that Jesus said before He left, He told the disciples, He says, I'll not leave you comfortless. He said, I'm going to send the Holy Spirit. The Holy Spirit is known as the Comforter, and we have the comfort of the Holy Spirit this day. The Bible tells us we sorrow not as those that have no hope, because in Jesus Christ we have the blessed assurance of who He is and our life in Him. And so the Comforter, the Holy Spirit, is with us. And it's a time of natural sorrow, and it's a time of natural grief, yet we can look on the good things, and we can remember the good times that Steve gave forth just a small glimpse of who his mother was. We look for those good things and remember the good things. We all go through trials and tribulations. The Bible says even though we go through the valley of the shadow of death, we don't have to fear any evil, because His rod and His staff, they comfort us. And so it is that as we celebrate Dorla this day, we
we know that the Word brings comfort, the Word of God. I read to you from 1 Thessalonians 4th chapter. It says, "But I would not have you to be ignorant, brethren, concerning them which are asleep, or those that have passed on, that you sorrow not even as others which have no hope. For if we believe Jesus died and rose again, even so them also which sleep in Jesus will God bring with him. For this we say unto you by the word of the Lord, that we which are alive and remain unto the coming of the Lord shall not prevent them which are asleep. For the Lord himself shall descend from heaven with a shout and the voice of the archangel, and with the trump of God, the dead in Christ shall rise first. Then we which are alive and remain shall be caught up together with them in the clouds to meet the Lord in the air, and so shall we ever be with the Lord. Wherefore, comfort one another with these words." I find that great comfort to know that Jesus Christ gives us that assurance in him that he is coming. And we don't have to sorrow. We sorrow for ourselves. The grief is for ourselves. We don't have to sorrow for Dorla this day. She's with the Lord. We actually sorrow for ourselves, but we don't sorrow as those that have no hope. So I appreciate that. You know, Dorla was part of that generation that some have called the greatest generation. Dorla was born during the Depression. She was born in 1930. Born during the Depression as a little girl growing up. She would have been a teenager about halfway through World War II. She lived through that time. She married in 1950, the start of the 50s. She lived through some of America's most trying times, but she remained free in her spirit. She was filled with joy. Steve shared with me, he shared with us some of the words that he gave earlier, and he shared with me some of the times that he had with his mother. And like all of us, we have good times, we have bad times. The Bible says he knows our coming in and our going out, is the way the Bible puts it. Our down settings and our uprisings, God knows it all. But through life, we have that assurance that he's here, but we can live our life to the fullest. Some people think being a Christian or getting into the Bible or following the principles of God is some kind of drag on us. It really is life and that more abundantly. It really frees us up to really enjoy life. And Dorla, I'm sure she had some trials and tribulations, but she remained free in her spirit, conscious of God. Steve shared how she would make the boys pray at night. It's kind of something that's been lost. That generation, her generation, seemed to understand those things more than today. People think they're more educated, more sophisticated. But people that really know things know God, and they raise their children up in the fear and admonition of the Lord. You see, the Bible tells us that the fear of the Lord is the beginning of wisdom. The fear of the Lord is the beginning of knowledge. And I can see by the simple things that we heard concerning Dorla that she wanted her boys to know there is a God. And a simple prayer of, "Now I lay me down to sleep, I pray the Lord my soul to keep," has much to say about God and his word. Because we do commit ourselves unto him. And I see that Dorla had her sons praying that simple prayer. What she's telling her sons is, "I want you to be raised with the knowledge of God. I want you to be raised with the knowledge of not just what you're going to learn in the secular realm, but there's another part of knowledge that only comes from honoring God." And it's as simple as a prayer of a child singing bedtime prayers. I also heard how she had a picture of Jesus in her house in the Bible. That speaks a lot to me. People don't have pictures of Jesus in their house unless they have some kind of connection with him. It's almost like today the mention of Jesus Christ is not the thing to do. Even a lot of Christian churches have trouble even mentioning the name of Jesus Christ, lest they offend somebody. Jesus said, if you're ashamed of me, I'll be ashamed of you. Obviously, Dorla wasn't ashamed of Jesus Christ. She had a picture, had his picture on her wall. Interesting enough, we have her picture on the cross today. And you can see her when she was younger. And I'm glad that we were able to put that right there on the cross. We all have to put ourselves on the cross and know who Jesus is. It was Jesus who said, I am the resurrection and the life. He that believes in me, though he were dead, yet shall he live. That's what he's talking about. That's what the word is speaking to us. It's not a harsh word. The Bible tells us he's faithful and just to forgive us our sins. All of us have sinned and come short of the glory of God. God doesn't have favorites. He doesn't have Christians first class, Christians second class, and third class. He only has those that honor him, calls them his children, the children of God. And we're all the same. He's no respecter of persons. The good news I have for you today is Dorla's not here. We don't have, like we do so many times, a casket with a body in it. As you know, she was cremated. We don't have even the ashes here today. But it doesn't make any difference if we had a body, if we had ashes. Because she's not here. Dorla had some physical problems later in life. I think as we all get older, we can understand that. Her life become a little bit harder, as Steve pointed out, as she broke her hip. And life become a little harder at the end for Dorla. But she has a new body. That's why it's not that important that we don't have the old body here. She has a new body. Let me read to you from the Word of God again. 2 Corinthians 4 or 5 here gives us a good picture of that. It says, while we look not at the things which are seen, but at the things which are not seen. For the things which are seen are just temporary, but the things which are not seen are eternal. For we know that if our earthly house, this tabernacle, were dissolved, we have a building of God, a house not made with hands, eternal in the heavens. For in this we groan earnestly, desire to be clothed upon with our house, which is from heaven. Therefore we are always confident, knowing that whilst we are at home in the body, we are absent from the Lord. For we walk by faith, not by sight. We are confident, I say, and willing rather to be absent from the body and present with the Lord. That's the picture that God gives us. This is just a temple we live in. Dorla's temple, God, all. She had 82 years living in that temple. God says, I've got a better one for you. I've got a building not made with hands. And he said, if this temporary house be destroyed, we've got a better one for you. To be absent from the body is to be present with the Lord. I was reminded as I was looking at this scripture and contemplating the words here about Dorla. Scripture that I just read to you reminded me of an old song that would have been popular when Dorla was a young girl. In 1954, a song was very popular. In fact, it became number one on pop charts. It was a song sung by Rosemary Clooney. And it was a song called This Old House. And the nature of the song was, ain't it going to need this house no longer? That's what the chorus tells. Ain't going to need this house no longer. Ain't got time to fix the shingles. Ain't got time to fix the floor. Ain't got time to oil the hinges nor to mend the window pane. Ain't going to need this house no longer. I'm getting ready to meet the saints. That's what the scripture tells us. This old house, this temporary house that we have, Dorla didn't need it any longer. She's got a new one. Dorla didn't need the suffering. She didn't need to live in that house. 82 years was long enough. And just as that song says, it had kind of a double meaning. You see, we have a temporary house that we all live in, but we have this house that our soul and our spirits are housed in. You see, we're made up of body, soul, and spirit. And this old body, it will fail. But God gives us the assurance that absent from this old body is present with Him. Dorla has a new house today. I believe Dorla is rejoicing in the presence of God. I believe that she would like me to tell you, Jesus Christ is faithful and just to forgive us our sins, all sins and unrighteousness. I believe she would have me tell you today, if I could say to her, Dorla, what would you want me to tell the people? I believe she would say, tell them to come where I'm at. It's a lot better. Tell them to yield their heart to Christ and have that assurance, the blessed assurance, that we have that hope eternal that absent from the body is truly present with Him. Come on, close today, and I just pray that the Word will stir within you. I pray that God will touch every one of you. It's an opportunity where we all have to say, God, I know that I don't know how long I have. The Bible says, boast not yourself of tomorrow, because you know not what the day may bring forth. If you look in the obituary, you'll see young people as well as old people. People with money, people that are poor. When our time has come, it behooves us to be ready to meet the Lord. Let's pray. Our Heavenly Father, we thank You for Your assurance. We thank You for Your Word, Lord, that tells us that we can, all of us, have that assurance, Lord. We thank You that the things which we see are just temporary. And if we live to be 100, it's still a small time compared to eternity. And I pray, Lord, that every one of us would just say in our hearts, even now, Lord, forgive me of my sins. Cleanse me from all unrighteousness. I commit my life to You. I want to be what You want me to be. I want to include You in my plans. And Lord, You said You'd go with us always to the end. And I thank You this day for everyone here. I thank You, Lord, as we go our separate ways, Lord, that You'll watch over and protect us. I pray that we'll always be conscious, Lord, of who You are and commit our lives fresh and new unto You this day and for the rest of our lives. We give You praise and glory and thanks for these things now. In Jesus' name, amen. May the Lord bless every one of you this day. I pray you have a good day in coming weeks and that you'll truly treat one another the way God would have us to treat one another. Love your brothers. He said, if you love me, you're to love one another even as I love. Lord bless you for your goodness today. We'll dismiss you in the name of the Lord.
Yeah, I'm going to be over.
What?
Huh?
Back here and greet the people.
Okay. Go back there and greet the people.
Oh.